Hi, I'm Alex, and welcome to Super Make Something. In today's minis episode, we take a look at the newly released Raspberry Pi 02W.
This episode is sponsored by PCBWay. Start bringing your next project to life by visiting PCBWay.com. Also, please like and subscribe. When the original Raspberry Pi Zero released in November 2015, it was a big deal. At roughly the size of a pack of gum, the Pi Zero contained a 1 GHz processor and 512 MB of RAM, giving it the same computational power as the full-sized Raspberry Pi B Plus that had released just a year and a half earlier for only $5. The ante was upped again a year and a half later when the Raspberry Pi Zero W released in June 2017. This version retained the same tiny form factor and added 802.11b, g, and n, as well as Bluetooth 4.1 and Bluetooth Low Energy, which allowed makers to ditch their networking dongles and create truly connected, embedded computing projects. For $10, the world now had access to a seemingly perfect single-board computer that could be used for anything from creating a handheld emulation console to internet-enabled motion sensors that would send a tweet to remind you to take your lunch to work. Surely science had reached its limit. Well, hold on to your hats, because the Raspberry Pi Foundation just announced the Raspberry Pi Zero 2W, a brand new single-board computer that retains the networking functionality and 512 megabytes of RAM of its younger sibling, but replaces the Broadcom BCM2835 system on a chip that has a 1 GHz single-core ARM11 CPU with a Raspberry Pi-designed SoC that has a 64-bit quad-core Cortex A53 processor, similar to the one found in the Raspberry Pi 3B+. Running at 1 GHz and supporting Bluetooth 5.2, the $15 Pi Zero 2W is a multi-core powerhouse with better networking capabilities than its predecessors, making it the perfect single-board computer for your next project that requires a lot of compute in a tiny package. But while these specs are good on paper, how do they translate to real-world performance? To find out, I ran some system tests. After installing the latest version of the Raspberry Pi OS onto an SD card and configuring the install for remote desktop access, I logged into each machine via SSH and performed a series of benchmarks using the Sysbench testing suite. A single-core CPU test completed in 238.1 seconds on the 0W and 171.7 seconds on the 02W, which decreased to 43.9 seconds when run in multi-core mode. RAM performance is also significantly faster, completing in 5.2 seconds on the 0W and 1.2 seconds on the 02W. Finally, an integer counting test between 0 and 1,234,567 was also faster on the new hardware, completing in 111.3 seconds on the 0W and 37.7 seconds on the 02W. Impressive. While the 0 line has arguably always been meant for embedded computing purposes, I also checked the performance of the 02W running in desktop mode and was pleasantly surprised. Those familiar with the Raspberry Pi desktop will feel right at home, and accessing menu items and configurations felt a bit zippier on the 02W than its predecessors. Web browsing using Chromium still causes the CPU usage to skyrocket though, and tasks like watching YouTube are a non-starter, but basic offline tasks like editing text files and Python code no longer max out resources like they did in previous Pi Zero variants, which makes using the desktop a much better experience. While these tests only begin to explore the 02W's upgraded capabilities, they indicate that this new Raspberry Pi is a worthy addition to the Zero line, which will allow makers to create even more impressive projects than we could before in the same footprint that we already know and love.
Overall, I'm extremely impressed with the Pi Zero 2W and can't wait to explore the capabilities of this board further. A big thank you to Raspberry Pi for sending out the Zero 2W for this first look video. The board is available right now and can be purchased at any of the links in the video description. Do you have a project in mind that you want to build with the Zero 2W? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video and want to see more episodes like this, please be sure to give this video a like, subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell icon to be notified about my latest uploads. Your support helps YouTube recommend this video to a larger audience and helps me make more episodes like this in the future. Based on my early tests, the 02W is the perfect embedded computing platform for maker projects. I already have tons of electronics projects in mind that I can't wait to get started on, so be sure to follow me on social media for a behind-the-scenes look of what I'm working on next. Of course, what would electronics projects be without custom circuit boards? So I also want to say a big thank you to PCBWay for sponsoring this episode. PCBWay manufactures super high-quality circuit boards at great prices, and I rely on them for all of my PCB needs. PCB Wayboard ships super quickly, with my orders always arriving in less than a week, and they recently added new solder mask colors, including pink, orange, gray, and transparent. Not only that, they also offer 3D printing, CNC, sheet metal fabrication, and injection molding services, allowing you to create any project that you can dream up. Be sure to check them out at PCBWay.com. Well, that's all there is to this episode. Thanks for watching. Now go super make something.